I'm gonna do something here that's one of my favorite things to do. I'm gonna make some mate, and while I typically prepare it in a mate gourd, today I'm gonna prepare it in my coffee maker, also known as my mate maker. Very easy to do and very delicious. Makes a lot of mate relatively quickly. So what I'm gonna do is use my favorite kind of mate today. It is the San Mateo mate. And it's made by Guayaquil. What I'm gonna do is just pour it straight into the filter, the coffee maker. I put in quite a bit of mate because I like it strong and it tastes really good like this. So all I really have to do is close this, add water, and turn the button on. But what I like to do is protect some of the nutrients, and this is totally an unnecessary step for all intensive purposes, but works great is to pour just a little bit of cold water on top of the mate and let it absorb it. That's going to protect all the nutrients and the flavor. So then I'm just going to add the water to the coffee maker, to the mate maker, and let it go. And turn it on, and away she goes. Now, one of my favorite things here is that this new bag of Guayaquil that is in a foil bag is completely biodegradable. It's made from all biodegradable materials. And as I read up more on this, I found out that it's made from paper, from wood fiber pulp that's sourced from trees that are sustainably managed. That are either working toward FSC or at ISO 14000 standards, which is amazing. So from what I've seen is that this bag will actually biodegrade in 180 days or less. So let's go check it out. We've got some in the garden already breaking down. Be right back to get our mate. This is a bag that I put in the ground on summer solstice, and it's been about 60 days. And you can see that it's already almost completely broken down into just little bits of, oh, look at that, there's some earthworms in there. It's creating a habitat for earthworms, and soon this will be soil. Now from what I've studied about this material is that the paper pulp basically breaks back down into soil, and the thin layer of aluminum that is only 2 armstrongs thick turns into an inert type of metal called aluminum oxide, which is inert. And so basically the entire package protects the mate from light and from heat, and at the same time is totally biodegradable and compostable in your garden. And I'm not doing anything, this isn't even under the ground. If it were under the ground, like these pieces here, it would go even faster. And it's working pretty well. Meanwhile, back at the mate maker, let's take a quick look here, see what's happening. You can see how the water is coming in and splashing on the mate. And it looks like it's doing a fairly good job. Just about done. Perfect, now my mate is done. And I'm just gonna, since it's summer, I'm gonna make delicious iced mate. So I'm gonna take this strong brew of mate that I just made, and I'm gonna put some honey first, just for fun. A little drizzle of honey on some ice. And I'm gonna put in some lemon verbena leaves that I collected from my garden. Now I'm gonna take my strong batch of mate and just pour it right on in the cup. It's a good strong brew. Give it a little stir. Delicious. Now, if I want to make my mate stronger, what I could do is pour the brewed mate right on top of the existing mate. And this process actually goes really fast because it just needs to drip right back down into the vessel. So you can see it already went really quickly. It's totally an optional step. I only do it every once in a while. And the other cool thing about mate is that it loves to give, so just like drinking it out of the gourd where you continually add water to it, I could add a whole nother fresh batch of water to this mate and it would brew again. And similarly with the gourd, you can tell that a mate is washed or lavado when the stems rise to the surface. The beautiful thing about the stems is not only do they have more theobromine, which is the active compound that makes you feel euphoric, but it also makes the mate sweeter. So sweet and smooth, two of my favorite characteristics with mate. The final step is to take my mate grinds and add them to my compost pile. So I'm going to add these right in here with my onions and avocados and strawberries and help nourish and give back to the earth. And when I'm done with my package of San Mateo, it's almost there, I'm just going to dump this right on in there as well. Let it decompose right in the yard. And I say, sometimes I feel like I could do anything, and sometimes I'm so alive, so alive. Sometimes I feel like I could zoom across the sky, and sometimes